Early Childhood Development Network of Pakistan, or ECDNP, in collaboration with the Ministry of Federal Education and Professional Training and key partners, organized the first ever National Conference on Early Childhood Care and Education, or ECCE, in Pakistan.
It is expected that this conference will give a new impetus to our collective efforts in achieving the various objectives regarding the practice of early childhood care and education in Pakistan.
Our three areas, three main objectives which we have set for us.
One is bring all the stakeholders to one forum and instill the sense of networking. Second, review the current status of ECCE in Pakistan and chart a future direction for its growth. And third, establish a forum to share and learn best practices and disseminate research on ECCE.
Around 500 registered delegates, including senior government officials from federal and provincial governments, ECCE experts, academic practitioners, planners, health professionals, teachers, and representatives of national and international NGOs participated in the conference. The theme of the conference was Envisioning Holistic Early Childhood Care and Education for Pakistan, Creating an Equitable, Pluralistic, and Sustainable Society.
When we talk about holistic and inclusive approach towards that, it's not just education ministries or education departments or people who are concerned with education. It is also the health ministries and health departments. I'm sure that this conference will be instrumental in deciding us on the path which we are going to treat.
We are happy to consider and look at the recommendations if they offer opportunities and prospects for creating closer synergies between Tibet and ECCE.
The conference brought together ECCE experts and practitioners to a platform to share experiences and highlight the ECCE need in Pakistan. Over 100 delegates from Pakistan and abroad presented their research and expert views at these sessions, and key organizations from around the country presented their work on ECCE.
The new knowledge on child development has revealed that the period from conception in the age of 8 is critically important in a child's life, because brain development, it is at its fastest in these years. Fitting interventions for children's holistic development in this age impacts outcomes across the entire course of its life. Today, children who are not adequately educated cannot participate in modern economy, and they are likely to become a drain on society.
1 million words would have never expressed so clearly what are the benefits of early childhood development. Your dedication and commitment to make this event happen is proof of your strong commitment for children.
These conferences, they are not sufficient until the message goes beyond the four walls. And for that, it's very important that the good papers should be published. And we are going to offer a platform here at Rupani.
Children not to be in poverty, and children should not be in hunger. All forms of malnutrition, global maternal mortality ratio has to be cut back, and preventable deaths of newborns. The cause and consequences of survival and development are very much linked, and I think the measures for both survival and development, if we plan this properly and implement this well, then I think we can get benefits. Both survival and development goals can be met, and there is opportunity for real synergy, efficiency, and economy.
In Punjab, we have established learning corners and ideal workspaces for children where they can learn in a simulated and real-life situation. And in these EC centers, we are concentrating on language and literacy library corners, creative arts, basic mathematical concepts, the world around us, the science corners, the personal and social development, home corner, health and hygiene.
There are three fundamental mandates of the EC Internet of Pakistan. We thought that it should be a national forum of networking amongst ECD organizations, ECD stakeholders in any role and respect. When you say ECD stakeholder, it's such a broad term. You know, any caregiver in a small setting is a stakeholder. We thought this should be an advocacy forum for promoting ECD issues nationally and a policy forum to promote and influence national discussion on ECD, its benefits and its role in the national reform and development.
We developed our early childhood education department in 2008 with the purpose basically to prepare teachers for these early childhood schools. But gradually we realized that the field is far beyond simply training teachers, so we expanded our programs. If we come to the program, the program which we currently are offering is a postgraduate diploma in early childhood education, which we developed about a year and a half back, and its first batch is already under the process of training with us. We intentionally kept it limited to federal territory, and we enrolled 40 students in our first batch and took it as a pilot run of the project.
Not just one element to pick and focus. Perhaps there are four different areas: the early stimulation, nutrition that really nourishes the brain, proper nutrition, and positive interactions through education, and also the safety element. If a child is not feeling safe, then the growth or the development of the brain is clearly compromised.
The ECD programs which Rupani Foundation running are Aga Walidain, Informed Parents, which targets parents, families and children from prenatal to 3. And after successful implementation of this Aga Walidain in Gilgit, now the Rupani Foundation has started replicating this approach with the help of communities in Gilgit-Baltistan and rural areas of Sindh.
All the family members of the Rupani Foundation centers are actively participating in the activities of the program, and they are involved in the decision making of the foundation. So this the Aga Walidain approach has really become very popular among the communities wherever it's implemented.
One important thing I would like to mention about the Open Society Foundation's initiative is the critical thinking in education. We implemented this program. This is a professional development program for teachers that links with the curriculum development, that will link with the textbook development and the assessment system. We implemented this program in all the Citizens Foundation schools, but then as I mentioned that the focus is very much on the public sector. So then we started with working with the Teachers Resource Center, and through them we have involved all the government institutions in this program.
We are looking at solutions, indigenous solutions in Pakistan. And as I said, our work is implementation and we create partnerships. And we realize that a lot of our youth are now very able and educated in the corners of Balochistan, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Fata.
Nearly 22 million children are out of school. The 8.63 million children are at primary school, and out of which 4.6 million are enrolled in public sector. And over 4 million children are in the private sector.
हम अर्ली चाइल्डहुड एजुकेशन को जो हमने एजुकेशन के साथ किया हुआ है कि क्वालिटी एजुकेशन सिर्फ और सिर्फ प्रिविलेज क्लास के लिए इलीट क्लास के लिए हो गई है और आम आदमी के बच्चे को क्वालिटी एजुकेशन का हक नहीं है. वंस अगेन वी आर डूइंग द सेम थिंग विद अर्ली चाइल्डहुड एजुकेशन.
बच्चों को पहले से ही इंडिपेंडेंट करें, उनको क्लियर करें कि नेक्स्ट ग्रेड में क्या होने वाला है आपके साथ. आप स्कूल एक तरीके से प्लानिंग करें जहाँ पर बच्चों को एक्सचेंज विजिट करा सके, कंबाइंड लेसन हो सके, टीचर्स की मीटिंग हो सके.
सो व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट मोस्टली थ्री थिंग्स, इट्स एक्सेस, द reach in program delivery. Have we reached the child with some kind of program, or have we provided the child with a reach to a program? And then what program we deliver? Is it classroom teaching, or a nutrition, or an educative program, parent education? And though these two are important, but what's more important is not a child's enrollment in a program. At the end of the program, is the child hitting the milestones, the developmentally appropriate milestones? If the child is hitting benchmarks, access is obtained.
A strong ego already exists within a child, and if it is nurtured in a facilitating environment of freedom, self-discovery and self-learning, is going to develop a strong identity of the individual who is possessed with self-respect and become the most beneficial member of the society.
When we talk about the holistic care, so there is an equal partnership between a father and a mother, a husband and a wife.
Sometimes the teachers feel that they are also restricted. They want to do, but they cannot do without the support of communities, without the support of their higher management, and without the support of their families.
Home, school, community learning center, community-based school places, or even working places. We are learning. So children can learn, not only in the schools, many places. I believe that Pakistan has a very rich experience of the non-formal education approach, which can be applicable to ECCE. And adult literacy and then community learning programs can be interlinked with this ECCE. So ECCE doesn't mean that only for the classroom, only child care, because that the adult literacy have a lot of that programs to develop that the capacity of the parents and then develop that the capacity of the community. So these interlinkages can be one of the approach in Pakistan.
Revamp of the teaching methodology to bring in not only lecture-based, but every sort of inquiry-based method, project method, any kind of method which would involve the students into learning and which would simply make them willing learners.
It is so important that you give the child the resources, the environment, the flexibility, the freedom, so that the child's natural faculties can be nurtured, so that the child can achieve his or her full potential. That's all holistic ECD is all about.
Keith L. Moore's book on human development, that is a textbook of first profession of medical education. He says embryology is discovered by Islam and by Quran. And I said, because I'm Hebrew and I'm not going to change my belief, but I know the early childhood development before, after conception and development, given pictorially in Quran, and is not given anywhere.
Almost a quarter of our children are in the vulnerable age groups for almost all the domains of development.
What is important is that we need to understand the developmental health status of our populations of children, and that can allow the organizations and the policy makers to make informed decisions and programs and interventions that support children's greatest need, whatever is identified in whichever community. As a nation, our ambition and desire is to have children who are physically and emotionally healthy, successful in learning and socially engaged and responsible.
But ECCE जो होती है वो खाली एक document होता है. Government चाहे तो उसको implement करे, चाहे तो ना करे, resources हैं तो कर दे, नहीं है तो नहीं करे. हम उसको challenge कहीं नहीं कर सकते, उसको responsibility लिया नहीं है. हमारा काम ये है कि हमने उनको law के अंदर amendment करवानी है, जो free and compulsory act है, हमें policy की ज़रूरत नहीं है. हमारा काम ये है कि हम 5 to 10 years अब ये काम शुरू कर देंगे. The government should be responsible to include in free and compulsory act एज को रिड्यूस करें और जो 5 ईयर तक बच्चे हैं उस पर अपनी एजुकेशन को बेहतर करें.
द लिमिट्स ऑफ इंडिविजुअल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स और ट्रेट्स आर फिक्स्ड बाय द हेरिडिटी एंड एनवायरनमेंट कैन ओनली पॉलिश दीज ट्रेट्स अप टू सर्टेन लेवल बट कांट सरपास दैट लिमिट्स व्हिच आर फिक्स्ड बाय द हेरिडिटी.
तब तक हम इंतजार करेंगे कि लेजिस्लेशन कौन करेगा. आप जैसे लोग ही हैं जिन्होंने गवर्नमेंट को इम्पोज करना है. अपने राइट्स के लिए तो हम जुलूस भी निकाल लेते हैं, सड़कों पर भी आ जाते हैं. तो वाई नॉट फॉर द रिक्वायर्ड लेजिस्लेशन फॉर एजुकेटिंग आवर यूथ और आवर जनरेशन.
So for health and education, the children have to be made prioritized. Until and unless they are not made our priority in every sector, we won't be able to devise correct policies, the suitable policies for our children.
You know, there are two types of budgets. In the current and in the development budgets, they have given a value that the pre-primary will be a separate line item. And when we evaluate the line items, we'll find out that it's mostly the construction budget which they are allocating to the divisions, to the districts. But there is no formal concept. Like we talk about the teachers, we talk about the material, we talk about the teachers' training. All these aspects are missing. But we find a small figure which is covering the construction work in their schools, like some additional rooms. But when we overall analyze the all budget of the whole Pakistan, the federal and the provincial, 3% of the budget is given at the federal level to the education. And in Punjab, it is 19%. Altogether, 313 billion amount is expended for the education. And in Sindh, it is 176 billion. The 20% of the total budget, and in KPK it is 143 billion, 28% of the total budget of the province, and in Balochistan we are spending 49 billion, that is a 17% of the total budget. And you see, we don't have any proper formula to identify that what actually we need to put for the education.
Norwegian Afghanistan Committee's innovation establishing play group in the remote area. This play group is like a very less, very informal group, that is where the children are in the around themselves. They are leaving place, they are working and they are together playing. Children are coming together in one place, that is parents selected that place, and also the children play according to their own wishes but with support of guidance from one adult, which was called facilitator.
Government jo hai wo ye dekh rahi hai ki jahan kis teacher nahi hai wahan teacher ko appoint kiya jayega. और जहाँ पर हमारे पास बाउंड्री वॉल नहीं है, क्योंकि अदरवाइज किट जो है वो प्रॉब्लम होगा. तो हैज अ फेस मैनर में वी आर टेकिंग दिस इनिशिएटिव.
व्हाट आई फील इज दिस इज अ गवर्नमेंट्स रिस्पांसिबिलिटी एंड गवर्नमेंट नीड्स टू फुलफिल दिस रिस्पांसिबिलिटी. देयर इज नो डोनर हु इज गोइंग टू पुट इन हिज मनी और हर मनी. आई थिंक गाइस वी हैव टू वेक अप ourselves. I being a Pakistani, I have to wake up. Civil society has to work, government has to play its part, and the businesses, whoever make money out of it, have to put in their money too. Otherwise, I don't see the level of stunting which this country is at this point in time, we can ever get back from that stage. 65 is too high a stunting rate. I don't think anyone would say, I being a Pakistani, I will say it, and it's my responsibility to put it up there, that we as development workers need to make sure, make government accountable and responsible for doing its duty so that these stunting rates do not get into the next years.
These sessions generated engaging discussions on the conference theme and sub-themes. An attractive piece of the national conference was the poster presentations on ECCE projects and best practices that captured the attention of the participants. The poster presentations made by Beacon House School System, Right to Play, Mehnaz Fatima Educational and Welfare Organization, and Kitabi Dost were well received by the participants. The presenters got the audience engaged in informal discussions to explain the content of their posters, encompassing the various ECCE components, ranging from the concept of inclusive and holistic ECCE to new instructional approaches.
Once the baby is born, the first 2 to 3 years are very important, and these are called first 1,000 years, when brain is developing to some extent. After we have passed those 1,000 days, the anatomical development of brain stops. There are no new cells, there are no new synaptic connections. So whatever we have had, we live with that throughout our life. So that's why it's important to concentrate on those very first period, 1,000 days, which is called early childhood in our case.
A child or a mother who is malnourished needs continuity of care. And then we don't know what catchment population is under coverage of each facility. It is not easy really to follow up those defaulters or the mothers who need continuity of care. So we propose establishment or implementation of family practice approach, which is implementing in many countries of the region. And with the guidance and leadership of Her Excellency Minister of Health, hopefully we will start implementing this in 10 districts of Pakistan. When you go to any BHUs or RHCs, there is no sufficient enough medical report and record about the family. On the best position, a mother has a vaccination card, which on the back side of that you have a growth monitoring chart, which is not everywhere. And there are many, I have a copy of vaccination chart without growth monitoring. So we should have some record and reports at the facility, either electronic or hard copy, for which we call it family folder. Ladies and gentlemen, let us join hands towards improving mother and child health in Pakistan.
Integrated within existing health system is feasible and has benefits for kids, which can be carried over till preschool age. And we are following these kids up now at 8 years and see if we have some sustained benefits at 8 years while they're in primary school. And in terms of policy, I think health sector is the best place, and they should advocate for integration of stimulation interventions in LMIC, not to just improve maternal and child health, but also improving children's learning outcomes for children to be prepared for school.
The state of school playgrounds in Rawalpindi in Islamabad, this was our research area, and we had a sample of 500 students in selected 4 schools in Rawalpindi and Islamabad. We observed that most care centers and private schools for low and middle income groups are located in converted residential units with limited space that denies children the opportunity for physical development and for cognitive and social learning in school environments. In contrast, most state schools have adequate school grounds. Sadly, it is observed that too few of these institutions encourage their children to fully utilize the existing school grounds, and none have developed their open spaces for creative play.
To address the stunting issues in Sindh province, Sehat Mand Sindh program on nutrition is about to kick on, and we are very much hopeful that this Sehat Mand Sindh program will also contribute in the early childhood education, will support that initiative.
We are working in isolation. I mean, government education is doing their own work, health is doing our own work, social welfare is doing on our own work in such seminar or meetings or international, you know, events we are together. But what we need is a multi-sectoral policy for all these challenges. where we can do, assess. The second thing, most important thing, we talk about SDGs, I think we should be committed, we are committed, and we should make a commitment to our own self that what we have done with SDGs, we are not going to do it with the SDGs. There's a committee in Parliament House, Speaker constituted a committee. Now there is a cell, separate cell in planning division. We have also created a cell in our own ministry. Then in education, and what we are proposing to SN Iqbal and we are soon going to have, and then a climate change also. For SDGs, we should have a committee at federal level who is going to monitor, and we are going to give a guidelines and a roadmap to the provinces that how we are going to implement this.
Both of them, girls and boys, should be treated with respect, dignity and trust. And these children should be provided with range of toys when they are very, very young kids, when they are of, even when they are born. We should provide them with toys which can be used by both girls and boys.
To bridge in the gap between the policy makers and the implementers, which is very obvious, we listen to the teacher's voice. We included the teacher's voice. On each and every step, our teachers were the actual part of designing and developing the system.
These are the ECCE models which Rupani Foundation is mainly focused on. The first is Aga Walden, which is prenatal to age 3, where we target from youth, then newlywed couples, and after that pregnant mothers, and then after delivery at 3 months, we register the child at our centers. So this program is a holistic program where we also have sessions for fathers, for grandparents, and for mothers also. And the second program, which I am more focused on, is Umeed, which is 3 to 8, and it is the proper and complete schooling program. And we, in Umeed program, we are working with community-based schools in interior Sindh and northern part of Pakistan, where the community is very marginalized. And the third program is FICD, Family Involvement for Child Development, where we train mothers to prepare for their child development.
Lots of times we are too busy either looking towards donors or either looking towards some international models, and without tailoring them to our requirement, we try to apply them across the board. I think we've got some amazing success stories out there. We've got indigenous models which are doing amazingly well. All we have to do is to kind of tailor them to our requirement and try to kind of implement those things which are tried and tested.
When we talk about inclusion, that means the children with and without special needs, they must be part of the mainstream classrooms. And mainstream classrooms means the public schools or the private schools that we have in Pakistan. The four dimensions are important in the inclusion: active participation of all children, services providing support for children, professional from different fields, and evaluation of children progress. Are we talking about all these things in ECE?
When we talk about mindset shift, it's not really the teacher who comes first to our mind or should come to first our mind. It's the teacher trainer whose mindset shift is more important. It's the curriculum planner, okay? From the curriculum and the entire philosophy of early childhood development and education, that's a source from where this mindset shift has to come into the society.
The one bright aspects of the public schools in sense is the purpose-built huge buildings.
This is one of the most brightest aspects which can be used for piloting and for introducing innovative projects within the public sector schools, and they have purpose-built buildings within huge vicinity, so you can utilize that very easily.
11 sustainable development goals are linked to early childhood care education target of 4.2. If we do it right, we handle poverty, we handle health, we handle nutrition, we handle gender equality, we handle environment, we handle so many more, and including economic growth, as you've heard, Heckman's principle of how 1 year or amounts, $1 spent on early childhood means $30 gained, you know, over the lifespan of the child. But sadly, the multi-sectoral aspect is not being addressed.
Another key feature of the conference was the showcasing of ECCE work implemented across various parts of the country. Several organizations, such as Rupani Foundation, Parvan, Power FM 99, Teachers Resource Center, Right to Play, and Roots International Schools, displayed a variety of materials developed for early childhood classrooms and teacher training. Over the 2 days, these stalls remained the center of attraction for everyone. Participants gathered around the stalls in large numbers and took keen interest in information on ECCE disseminated from these stalls. Interactive sessions, discussions, and presentations at the conference resulted into solid recommendations and actions for the future that were presented before the President of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, who was the chief guest at conference closing. The Honorable President commended the efforts to hold the important conference. He assured his full support to ensure quality ECCE services to all the children of Pakistan. Based on the momentum created by the National Conference on ECCE in Pakistan, and as desired by the Honorable President of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, it is proposed to initiate the implementation of the following key recommendations of the Conference on Priority. A standard definition of ECCE in Pakistan to focus on early childhood as the age from prenatal to 8 years. A national policy for ECCE needs to be formulated to address the specific needs and to set the goals for ECCE prenatal to 8 years. To develop an integrated curriculum for holistic ECCE from prenatal to 3 years of age. Review of ECCE curriculum in collaboration with National Curriculum Council. Review and development of teacher and facilitators training manuals. National budget and developmental plans to allocate funding for ECCE. ECCE centers of excellence to be established at universities, and the first such center to be established at the Allama Iqbal Open University. Social and cultural diversity needs to be addressed in the awareness campaigns that should be run to empower the communities in connection with ECCE. All the stakeholders at national, provincial, district, and local level need to join hands and remain connected through a web portal for sharing information beyond boundaries.